So hey guys, I'm Vinay Padegal, and today we're going to talk about generating a random permutation. Let me take you through what this problem entails. We are supposed to design an algorithm that takes uniformly random permutations of 0 to n minus 1. You have to generate it basically. You have to generate a uniformly random permutation of 0 to n minus 1. You are given a random number generator that returns numbers in the set 0 to n minus 1 with equal probability. Use as few calls to it as possible. This will be a little important, which we'll talk about later. So basically, if I had to explain that in layman's language, you have to basically create a permutation of n numbers, the numbers being 0 to n minus 1. And this might seem fairly simple, but if you were to talk about the brute force approach in this situation, let's say our numbers were basically, if n was 4, our numbers would be 0, 1, 2, 3. And in this situation, if we could have gone the brute force way of just calling this random number generator as many times as required until we get all the numbers in the given set, right? So we can just call the random number generator. Let's say we got the number 1 the first time, so we haven't generated 1 yet, so we keep that. Then the second time we call it, we get the number 2. So we haven't generated 2 also, so we keep that. And the third time when we call the random number generator again, we get the value 1. And since we already got it, we just discard it. Then we get the value 3. And since we haven't gotten that, we keep it. And then we get the value 1 again, which we already have, so we discard it. We get the value 3 again, which also we already have, so we discard it. And then we get the value 0, which we don't have. And that gives us 4 individual numbers, which was what we required. So our random permutation be 1, 2, 3, 0. That would be it. But as you'll notice here, if we are generating numbers in between 0, n minus 1 every time, we are bound to get a lot of duplicate generations, and we have to call this random number generator a lot of times. As compared to our efficient approach, which I will talk about right now. But calling this random number generator multiple times more than required will reduce the efficiency. And if we were to talk about the efficiency here, we would first of all also have to remember which numbers we've already generated, so that we can immediately discard a newly generated random number in case we had already generated in the past. So we can use a data structure like a hash table over here, which stores whether we have generated this current random number or not, and it can tell us that in constant time. So that will take a space complexity of big O of n, and calculating the time complexity for this is not as straightforward as the space complexity, because you might realize that in the beginning, when we have not generated any numbers yet, we will generate a lot of them easily, right? And we will get almost all of them being individual and not having generated them already before. But towards the end, when we have generated most of the numbers, generating the remaining few numbers will take a lot of attempts, right? We will mostly get all repeated numbers itself. So there's no real easy way of determining the time complexity here. But after a lot of calculations, it was determined that in this kind of situation, the time complexity would be about big O of n log n. So we are going to try to beat that and make it more efficient and more, a little more deterministic as such, because we can do that. And coming to our current approach, I would like to remind you of the algorithm that we discussed 2 lectures ago, where we were given an array of size n, and we were supposed to generate a random subset of size k, right? So given the integer k as well, of course. And what we did was we ran this for loop k times and swapped a of I, where I went from 0 to k minus 1. We ran it k times and we swap a of I with with a randomly generated index between 0 and I and n minus 1, essentially. So when I is equal to 0, generate a random number between 0 and n minus 1, and we swap the element at that index with a of 0, and then we reduce the range for the random number generation by 1. We generated between a of 1 and a of n minus 1, and swapped it with a of 1, and then for 2, and then for 3, and so on and so forth. So in each iteration, we reduced the size, the range for the random number generation by 1. Essentially, what we are doing here is we are avoiding any duplicate generations, right? After generating a random number, we swap it to the beginning, and then we never generate that again, because we are not including that in the range from which we are generating random numbers. So that essentially would be the approach that we used. This was the function that we used in that algorithm. Now we can just reuse that same function and finish our task over here also. So let me take you through how this works. First, we have a vector called permutation that holds integers, and it has a size n, and we can initialize the permutation to 0, 1, 2, 3 till n minus 1, and that's exactly what this iota function is doing. This is present in the STL standard template library in C++, and it starts from 0 and it goes to n minus 1. And after this, we have essentially initialized the permutation vector to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till n minus 1. And now what we're doing is we are calling random sample with permutation dot size as a k value. So k is equal to n itself, and we are sending the permutation array. So when we are given in the actual function, we were given an integer k, and we had to generate a random subset of size k from n numbers. Now if the integer k itself is n itself, we are supposed to generate a random subset of size n from n itself. So if we were to look at how that would go, let's say our i goes from 0 till n minus 1 included, right? So if I were to work on this example and show you how that would go, let's say currently our I is 0, and we generate a random number between 0 and 4, right? That's exactly what this is doing. The uniform int distribution is a function that is a random number generator. So between 0 and 4, we're supposed to generate a random number. So let's say we generate 3, right? So then we swap a of 0 with a of 3, and that would be a of 0 and a of 3. So we just swap that, and now we increment I to 1. And now in the previous iteration, we generated the random number between 0 and 4, indices 0 and 4. But now after we swap the index over here, now 3 is in the beginning of the array, and now we generate a random number between 1 and 4, right? So when we generate a random number between 1 and 4, we let's say the random number that we generate is 2, right? In that situation, we swap a of 1 and a of 2. That is, we bring 2 here and we bring 1 here, right? And as you'll notice, in every iteration, we are reducing the range from which we are calling the random number by 1. And in the second time, first time we called it, the range was from 0 to 4. But in the second time we called it, we put 3 in the first place, and then we are calling from 1 to 4. The range is 1 to 4, indices 1 to 4. And effectively what we're doing here is we are not including 3. By not including the index 0, we are never going to generate 3 as the number. So essentially we are avoiding generating duplicate numbers, like what we did over here, where we generated 1 again, 3 again, 1 again, 1 again, 3 again. We are not doing that here, right? After iterations I is equal to 0 and I is equal to 1, let's say now I is equal to 2, and the number, the random number we generated was 3 again, let's say. So we swap a of 2 with a of 3, and that gives us okay, so now I is equal to 3 now, and let's say the random number that we generated, now we are generating random numbers between 3 and 4 only, right? So let's say the random number we generated was 4. So we swap 4 and 3, and that's essentially it. Now we generate a random number between this only just four, so there's really nothing to do over that. That's just a non-trivial case, and we have a permutation of size n, which is 3, 2, 0, 4, 1. The important point note here is in each iteration we reduce the range from which we generate the random numbers. In the first iteration we generate between 0 and 4, and we put the whatever index we generated randomly, we put that element in the beginning. Now we generate the next iteration, we generate between 1 and 4 and then put that element in at the position 1, then between 2 and 4 put that element in the position 2, and then between 3 and 4 and put that in 3, and last position there's nothing you really need to do, it's just going to stay over there itself. And in this way it's we are going to be able to generate a random permutation. There are n factorial permutations totally, and it's going to be equally probable to generate any of them using this method. Now you'll see that the algorithm that we used, the random sample algorithm, had a running time of O(k), where k was the integer given to it. And since we are giving the integer n permutation.size itself, our time complexity is going to be O(n) itself. And since we are not using any extra space in here, as compared to the previous algorithm where we had to use a hash table to remember which numbers we had already generated, so that had the space complexity of O(n). But here we are going to be doing everything in place. We are not going to use any extra space as such, so we are going to achieve a space complexity of O(1) or constant space, and time complexity of O(n) or linear time. And that essentially brings us to the end of this explanation. This was fairly simple. We just had to use a function from one of our previous lectures, and I hope you like that. I hope you find that interesting.